Hello and welcome to the Abundology Podcast. My name is Renee Spears and I'm an abundance channeler and business mentor. And I help people be happy and have more money, love, time, and joy in their lives. I'm coming to you from a very beautiful downtown Portland, Oregon. And this is the weekly energy update for the week of November 1st, 2020. Every Sunday, I talk about how the energy is going to be for the week ahead, and I also infuse the show with some positive vibes, so you get a little positive energy boost just for listening. Today is the first day of November, 11-1, or 1-1-1, and in numerology, 1-1-1 has many meanings. The meaning I usually think of when I see it is that my thoughts are manifesting instantly. It's just a really good reminder to not only keep your thoughts positive, but also to think bigger, to elevate what you're thinking. Another meaning of 111 is that you are ready to start something new, a life event like moving to a new house, starting a new job or relationship, or maybe even a new direction for our country. So even if you've had a loss recently, the circumstance that you saw as a setback is the thing that launches you into a period of spiritual growth. The universe is offering us a fresh start. So last night was the full moon in Taurus. It is a powerful moon, and we are still in that full moon energy today. And today, Sunday, is All Saints Day, and Monday is All Souls Day. And as we talked about last week, Uranus, the planet of awakening and surprising news, is conjunct this blue moon, which means its energy will be really active. So whenever the moon and Uranus come together, there's always this chance of shocking information. Something's going to come out. And it can make you feel restless and anxious and impatient and jumpy. Like a sense of impending change can make it really difficult to relax. And I don't need to tell you that this election anxiety energy is in the air. And it is the main influence for our energy this week. Right now, we are experiencing a mental health epidemic, which is now more intense, even more so than it has been because of the election. 50% of people say their mental health has been suffering. I read an article in the New York Times this morning about alcohol use being up 17% in women, 14% in men, and the cannabis business is booming. I have a couple friends in the cannabis business, and their businesses are taking off. It's incredible. But we're experiencing grief for lost people, lost dreams, lost health, lost hope. Everything seems so uncertain right now. And when things are uncertain, we feel anxiety. Clearly, the big things are uncertain. We have the election and COVID, jobs and schools, but we're even missing the little certainties, like getting up and going to work on Monday morning, like Friday afternoon being the end of your work week, and maybe you go out and have cocktails with friends. Holiday celebrations, Halloween felt a little different this year. So those little uncertainties also add up. And if we add that to what's happening in the sky with all the planets up there and the full moon, Mercury going direct, Uranus is up there to conjunct things, our election anxiety is through the roof. So let's commit right now to being easy on ourselves for the month of November. Let's cut ourselves some slack this month. Let's take extra special care of ourselves this month. So what does going easy on yourself even look like? And it looks like taking it easy where nothing short of a true emergency is urgent. Email doesn't have to be checked. Deadlines don't have to be pursued. Laundry doesn't have to be done. Floors don't need to be mopped. This month, a messy house and a full inbox look like being easy on yourself. I give you permission to take this month and be easy. I also give you permission to clean the crap out of your home. So many of us, and I'm one of them, feel so much better when we clean our homes. Anxiety cleaning, I call it. It also has the, you know, added benefit of physically moving the anxiety energy out of your body. So the important thing this month is to listen to what you need, because that's different for all of us. Some of us need to take it easy and sit and eat chocolate all day and let our laundry pile up. Others of us, we know it makes us feel better to get up and clean everything and burn that energy off and eat healthy food. Listen to what you need and then give it to yourself. If you need to do nothing, do it without guilt. If you feel better making art or reading a book all day, do it without guilt. If you feel better finishing off the Halloween bag of Halloween candy, do it without guilt. If something is good or bad for you is determined by what you think about it. So if you think that eating a piece of chocolate cake is bad for you and you guilt yourself about eating it, then it will be. If you eat a piece of chocolate cake and you enjoy every bite and think of it as a way of going easy on yourself, it will be. Don't we love that? It's that simple. The problem most of the time is that we feel bad or guilty or shame for doing or not doing the things we know will make us feel better. So just for November, let's live without shame or guilt. Taking care of yourself is dropping the shoulds. Take should out of your vocabulary. Replace it with could or get to, and you'll find yourself less stressed. Taking care of yourself looks like breathing, doing one thing at a time, slowing down, taking a tech break. And because of the full moon in Taurus, being in nature helps so much. Last week, I suggested taking 2 walks a day could really help your mental health, and it did. I did 2 walks a day all last week, and it really helped me out. I'm definitely keeping that up this month. Taking care of yourself looks like letting stuff go. When you find yourself stressing over trying to do too much, let it go. I find it really helpful actually to like clench when I find myself in that spot of stressing, to clench my hands really tight and then unclench them. That's just the idea of letting it go when you unclench them. Taking care of yourself looks like focusing on the positive. And yes, that's a little bit harder right now than usual, but there are so many great things to focus on. I love to see so many people voting early and all the wonderful voting stories. The 104-year-old woman that voted, the college student that drove 20 hours to vote, all the stickers on the Susan B. Anthony tombstone, people handing out pizzas and cookies and meals to people in line, the elderly couple that everyone let move to the front of the line so they didn't have to wait. So focus on the positive and then store those thoughts so that when you do find yourself thinking about what could happen, all the bad things that could happen, shift your thoughts to all the wonderful things that are happening. So going easy on and taking care of ourselves is one of the best things we can do right now, not only for ourselves, not only for us, but for our families and society. We need balanced people, and keeping ourselves balanced helps others. So this month, do what you need to do to go easy and take care of yourself. And know that by doing that, not only is it the best thing for you, it's also the best thing for your family, for your coworkers, and for your country. So to me, taking care of myself looks like two walks a day, cleaning my home. I feel much better when my home is clean, and I love burning off like that excess energy. Intermittent fasting makes my body feel so much better. I'm taking care of myself by celebrating Election Day. I love Election Day. I'm a political junkie and I just love politics. So I've planned to make Election Day special, and I'm going to order pizza and drink beer on election night. So I'm so excited to have something to look forward to on that night. So take a few moments today to think about how you're going to take care of yourself this month. This is not the time to just wing it. Yeah, when I'm feeling like that, Renee, I'll just let it go. No, we need to get a plan. Plan taking care of yourself. Schedule Wednesday off after the election off so that you have a chance to maybe recuperate. Schedule an hour-long soak in the bath. Plan on a juice cleanse or baking your favorite dessert. Committing to this now during this wonderful full moon energy sets the intention for the next month. And as we know, it's up to us to take care of ourselves. So let's be adults and let's do that this month. So, okay, a couple weeks ago, I asked you to send some positive energy to my friend Shannon, whose dog Murray escaped and was missing. And I was hoping last week to be able to share the good news that he was found, but I couldn't. But I do get to do that this week instead. So Murray was missing for 11 days, and Shannon never stopped looking for him. He was lost in the forest, and they used cameras and traps and drones. And Shannon even walked up and down the logging roads in the dark, in the middle of the night, by herself, hoping he would pick up her scent. And he did finally turn up, like I said, 11 days later, miles away at somebody's home playing with their dog. And they saw his collar, and Shannon's phone number was on the little tag on his collar. She called him, and he got to come home. So that is so exciting. Another great story to focus on. But the moral of the story is, don't give up. This is not the time right now for us to give up on anything. Do what you need to do, even if it requires you to be extra brave and walk for miles by yourself in the dark, in the middle of the woods, looking for your dog that you love. We have got this, everyone. Although it may not seem like it right now, Trump is what we needed to wake us up to finally look at the injustices in our country and make changes so that it's better for everyone. Hang in there. We got this. Think on the bright side. Take care of yourself. Thank you for listening. Commit to going easy on yourself this month. Vote. And I will talk to you next week.